Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am going to explain you the concept of B-tree. In this video session, I am going to cover the concept of insertion of B-tree. Before performing insertion on B-tree, you must know the basic concepts of the B-tree. What is B-tree? What is the introduction of B-tree? What is an order of B-tree? What are the examples that already covered in my previous video session? For that, I am providing you a shortcut link over here. You can go through that and you can resume this current video. Here, I am assuming that all of you are knowing the concept of B-tree. Now, let's start with the properties of B-tree. I am going to explain all the properties with this example, where this is a B-tree whose order is 4. It means that the node will be having 4 minus 1, that is 3 number of keys. Every node maximum 3 number of keys can be hold, and the maximum 4 number of children can be there. Who decides the order of the tree? Now let's start with the first property. Property 1 tells us that all the leaf nodes must be at the same level. Here you can see that all the leaf nodes are available at the same level. Let's move to the property number 2, where this property tells about non-leaf nodes, which is not a root. All the non-leaf nodes must have m by 2 minus 1 number of keys and m by 2 number of children. Here this property is going to deal about the minimum count, that is m is nothing but the order of the tree. Now let's consider this example again, as this is the tree whose order is 4. 4 upon 2 is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. So at least 1 number of keys must be there in every node, and 4 upon 2 number of children, as a single key is there, minimum 2 children must be there in this B-tree. So this is the property who tells about the minimum number of nodes must present in the B-tree. Now let's go forward for the next property, who is going to deal about the maximum number of nodes as well as the maximum number of children can present in the B-tree. Here I am going to explain again the things with respect to non-leaf nodes who are not root node. So that the non-leaf nodes that must have maximum m minus 1 keys. If the order is 4, so maximum 4 minus 1 number of keys must be present, maximum. It should not get exceed the limit, that is m minus 1. And if m minus 1 keys are there, it should have m number of children. That is, if 3 nodes, 3 keys are there in every node, so it will be having 4 number of children. Here you can see that the node is having 2 keys, so 2 plus 1, 3 number of nodes are there, or child nodes are there. This is the first child, this one is the second child, and this one is the third child. If the third key value is present, then it will be having the fourth child node as well. So move to the next property, where the root node is a non-leaf node, then it must have at least 2 children. Now this property is going to deal about root node. So if it is non-leaf node, then it is having at least 2 children, because we are going to consider that at least one key value is present, must present in a root node, and if one key value is present, then it will be having at least 2 children, a first children and a second children. First children must be less than the root node, and the second will be greater than the root node. Let's move to the property number 5, that it is going to deal about the order or the sequence of the key values. So property 5 says that all the keys which are present in every node that should follow the ascending order within itself. So here you can see that you can take any of the node, like suppose this is the node who is having two values where both the keys are following the ascending order, they are 40 and 50. Now let's consider this is the node who is having three values in itself, 71, 73 and 75. All the values are following the order which is nothing but the ascending order. And now the last property is about the time complexity. So time complexity of any of the operation, that is, it may be search operation, it may be insert operation, it may be delete operation, it is big O log n, just same as of your binary search tree. So as of the binary search tree, it is having the same time complexity, but this is the tree which gives us a facility to store huge number of keys within itself. So now let's move forward for the algorithm which is going to use for the insertion operation in B-tree. Before that, we'll see that the B-tree, in the B-tree where the new node can be added. So always new element, new node, new key value will be added at the leaf node only. And we need to always keep in mind that all the leaf nodes must be at the same level. So let's start with the insertion operation algorithm. So this is algorithm where the first step is we need to check whether the tree is empty or not. If the tree is empty, our task is very easy, that in the step 2 I want to insert a node, that node is going to become a root node itself because my tree is empty. So if my tree is empty, insertion of the first element, first key value is very simple to make that key as a root node. Let's move forward for the step number 3. But if my tree is not empty, it means that already some values are available with my B tree. Then what to do? Then if my tree is not empty, then we need to find out the leaf node in which the new key value can be added. How are you going to find out that the which leaf node can hold the new key value? So that you can do with the help of BST logic. BST is nothing but the binary search tree logic, where the logic is all the nodes which are present in the left subtree are less than the root node, and all the nodes who are present in the right subtree are greater than the root node. By applying the same logic, you can find out the leaf node in which you can insert a new key value. So now in the step 3, you have decided in which leaf node you want to insert a new key value. Now let's move forward for the step number 4. What the step number 4 is going to explain us. So now step number 4 says that if that the leaf node has an empty position, correct? Because every leaf node or every node is having a size which is depend on the order of the tree. If order is 4, then the node size is 3. If order is 3, node size is 2. Accordingly, you need to find out whether the vacant position, empty position is available or not. If the empty position is available, then add the new key value in that node by maintaining the ascending order, because in every node within itself, it follows the or it is having all the nodes in the ascending order. So by maintaining this property, we can insert a new node, new key value in the node, leaf node, if it is having the empty position. Now let's move forward for the next property, sorry, next step, in which I am going to explain you if the leaf node is not empty, it is not having a vacant position, already it is full, then what we need to do. So if already the node is full, then in that case we need to perform the split operation. So what is the splitting of the node? In the splitting of a node, we are preparing or we are availing the position or a space for the insertion of new key value. So what we are going to do in the split operation? In the split operation, what we will do? We will split the node in the middle of the node, that is the value which is present in the mid of the node that we will send into its parent node. I will repeat this step till the splitting operation performs successfully. That is, if the middle value what I am going to send or which I am going to send into the parent node, if the parent node is also full, then the value, mid value from the parent node, that also we need to send into the upper level. So this step we need to repeat till the same, this step we are going to repeat until sending the value and getting fixed into the node. So in this way we need to repeat this step repeatedly till you are getting the space available for the insertion of new key value. Now let's move forward for the next step. If the splitting is occurring to the root node, because if we are moving into the upper level by applying this step repeatedly, step number 5 repeatedly, it may happen that you are at the root node. So if this is the situation where the splitting you need to perform on a root node, then you can find out a middle node and that you are going to form, you are going to use as a new root node. And in this way you can perform the splitting of a root node. With this you are going to increase the size of tree by 1. That you need to keep in mind. So whenever you are going to split the root node, you are going to increase the height of your tree by 1. So by applying these 6 steps, you can insert a new key value into your B tree. Now let's start with the example. Here I am trying to explain you the insertion operation in a B tree for the values 1 to 10. Repeat 1 to 10 one by one, for which I am going to consider the B tree for the order 3. Now let's start with the first one. As I want to insert a first node, as my tree is empty, so without any effort I am going to create a root node who is having a first value as 1. Now let's move forward for the insertion of value 2. 2 will get added just next key value in the same node as the size of my node is 2. Order 3 means maximum 2 values can be stored, 2 key values can be stored into every node, because order 3 is depend on the number of child node. So 3 children can be available for this node, and that's why maximum 2 values can be stored. So up to this 2 value we are not having any extra efforts, we are not getting any extra efforts for the insertion of this node. Now let's move forward for the insertion of the next key value, that is 3. Now as I want to insert 3, that I'll start with a leaf node. Currently my root node is leaf node itself. So now for the insertion of 3, what I need to do here, the space is not available, already node is full. So what I need to do, I need to perform split operation. What was the split operation? I need to choose the middle element and that I need to send to its upper level or the previous level. So after splitting, my tree will look like this. This tree node, 3 node will be a new node, because we need to maintain the order. We need to maintain a property of binary search tree where 2 is a root node. All the nodes who are available into the left subtree must be less than 2, and all the nodes which are available into the right subtree of 2 must be greater than 2. So that's why 3 is inserted as a new leaf node. Now let's move forward for the insertion of 4. While the insertion of 4, I'll find out the node where I can insert 4. So this is the node where I can insert a 4 by applying a binary search tree property. Search whether the vacant position is available. Yes, vacant position is available, and that's why I'm inserting 4 just next to 3. I'm maintaining the ascending order of the nodes and I'm inserting the node into the leaf node. I'm inserting a key value into the leaf node. Every time you need to check whether all the properties are going to satisfy or not. If it is not, then that could not be the binary sorry B tree. So every time take care of all the properties, whether all the properties are satisfying or not. If it is not, then find out a solution and then insert accordingly. Let's move forward for the insertion of next element, that is 5 in my tree. So if I want to insert a 5, according to binary search tree property, 5 must be present into the right subtree of 2. But for the insertion of 5, there is no any vacant space available. To make the space, we need to apply the split operation where I will move this 4, which is the middle element, to the upper level or to its parent. Now for the parent node, whether the space is available, yes, the space is available. That's why I'll move 4 to the upper level, and from this 4, after inserting or splitting, the node 5 is inserted as a new node. Now as 5 is inserted as a new node, here we can see that the property of the B tree we are going to follow, where all the nodes which are all the leaf nodes are at the same level, all the nodes are having all the keys in the ascending order, as well as order property also we are going to follow. That is, maximum 2 key values are there in the node and maximum 3 children are there. Now what is going to happen if I want to insert a next value, that is 6 in my tree? So 6 is get inserted very easily as the space is available for the insertion of 6. Now let's move forward for the 7. For 7, one level is going to increase because the space is not available for 7. 6 is moved upward to its parent, but again the space is not available. Then the splitting of the root node, where the middle value that I am going to choose and that I am going to send it to the parent node again, that is now 4 is now going to become a new root node, and in this way the height of the tree is increased by 1. For the insertion of next number 8, it will get inserted very easily. But for 9, again we need to perform the splitting operation. 8 is moved upward, space was available, then the 9 is inserted as the right child or in the right subtree of 8. Here you can see that the 6 and 8, two key values are present in a node where 5 is less than 6, 7 is greater than 6 but less than 8, and 9 is greater than 8. So here I am following all the properties of B tree, and the insertion of the last node, that is 10, the space is available and easily we can insert the node into the B tree as a leaf node. So friends, I hope all of you are getting how to insert a node into the B tree. Thank you for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content and the video, please like my video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Please do share it with your friends and keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos. Here I am providing you the subscription link for my channel Tech Talks. Here I am providing you the link for a next video from this video series B tree, and here I am providing you the playlist for B tree. Thank you, friends.